Daylight. It was a nightingale and not thy lark that pierced thine fearful howls of thine ear. Nightly she sits on the pomegranate tree. Believe me, love, it was a nightingale.
Let me be ta'en. Let me be put to death.
I'm content so thou wilt have it so. I'll say yon gray is on the morning's eye.
Aww.
'Tis but the pale reflex of Cynthia's brow. Nor that is not the lark whose notes to be. The vaulty heaven so high above our heads. I have more care to stay than will to go. Come death and welcome. Juliet was it so. How is it my soul? Let's talk it. It is not there.
It is, he hence be gone away. It is the lark that sings so out of tune, straining harsh discords and unpleasant sharps. Some say the lark makes sweet division, but that doth not be true, for she divideth us. Oh now, oh, some say the lark in loathsome toad changes eyes. Oh now, I would say that they change voices too, since arm from arm and voice doth us affray, hunting thee hence with hunts up to the day. Oh now be gone, more light and light it grows.
More light and light, more dark and dark it grows.
Madam!
Nurse!
Your lady mother is coming to your chamber. The day is broke, be wary, look about.
Then window, let day in, let life out.
Farewell, farewell, for one kiss and I'll descend.
Art thou be gone? So love, lord, a husband, friend? I must hear from thee every hour and every day. For there are many minutes in every day. Ere, by this count it may be many years. Ere again I behold my Romeo. Oh.
Farewell, I will omit no opportunity that may convey my greetings. Love to thee.
Oh, thinkest thou, shall we ever meet again?
I doubt it not, and all these woes shall serve. For sweet discourse is now a time to come.
Oh God, I have an ill-driven soul. Methinks me see thee, art thou so low, as if one in the bottom of a tomb. Either my eyesight fails, or thou lookest pale.
And trust me, love, in my eyes so do you. Dry sour drinks our blood, I do adieu.
Oh, fortune, fortune, aren't all men call thee fickle, if thou men are fickle? What does it thou with him that is renowned by faith? Be fickle, be fortune. For then I hope thou wilt not keep him long, but send him back.
Ho, daughter, are you up?
Who is it that calls? Is it my lady mother? Is she not down so late or up so early? What uncustomed calls is procedured?
How now, Juliet?
Oh, madam, I am not well.
Evermore weeping for your cousin's silvote death. Wait, will thou wash him from his grave with tears? And if those couldn't, looks could not make him live. Therefore have done, some grief shows much of love, but much of grief shows still some want of wit.
But let me weep for such a feeling loss.
So shall you feel the loss of your friend that you weep for.
Feeling so lost, I cannot choose but ever weep thy friend.
Well, girl, thou weepest not so much for his death, but for that the villain lives that slaughtered him.
What villain, madam?
That same villain, Romeo.
Villain, and he be many miles asunder. God pardon him, I do with all my heart, and yet no man like he doth grieve my heart.
That is because the traitor murderer still lives.
I, madam, from the reach of these my hands, would none but I might venge my cousin's death.
We will have vengeance for it, fear thou not. Then weep no more, I'll send one intimate to you, where that same man's friend he doth live. Shall give him such an unaccustomed dram that he should soon keep table company, and then I, though delve, should be satisfied.
Indeed I shall be never satisfied with Romeo till I behold him. Dead is my poor heart, for the kinsman vexed. Madam, if you could find but a man to bear a poison, I would but temper it, that Romeo should upon reciput, therefore, soon sleep in quiet. Oh, my heart abhors to hear him named, that cannot come to him. Oh, to wreck thy love, I bore my cousin upon his body that has slaughtered him.
Find all the means, and I'll find such a man. But now I tell these tidings joyfuls.
And joy comes in such an easy time. What time is this? Beseech me, your ladyship.
Well, well, those has a careful father, child, one who put thee
from thy heaviness hath sorted out a sudden day of joy that thou expects not, nor I look not for.
Madam, in happy times, what day is this?
Marry my child, early next Thursday morn, the gallant and noble gentleman, the Count in Paris, at St. Peter's Church, shall happily make thee a joyful bride.
Now, by St. Peter's Church and Peter too, he shall not make me a joyful bride. I wonder at this haster that I must wed, ere by this I should be my husband comes to woe. I pray to thee, tell my lord, my father, madam, I will not marry yet, and when I do, I swear it shall be Romeo, whom you know I hate, rather than Paris. This is nudity indeed.
Here comes your father. Tell him so yourself and see how he will take it.
When the sun set, the air doth drizzle dew, but for the sun set, my brother's son, it rains downright. How now, a contumely girl, but still in tears, evermore showering, and one little body thou counterfeits a bark, a sea, a wind. For still thy eyes, which I may call the sea, do ebb and flow with tears. The bark thy body is, sailing in the salt flood. The winds, thy sighs, who raging with thy tears, and they with them, without a sunny calm, will overset thy tempest-tossed body. How now, wife, have you delivered to her our degree?
Ah, sir, but she will none. She gives you things. I, the fool, will marry to her grave.
Soft, take me with you. Take me with you, wife. How will she none? Doth she not give us thanks? Is she not proud? Doth she not count her blessed? Unworthy as she is, that we have wrought so worthy a gentleman to be her bride?
Not proud that you have, but thankful that you have, for I cannot be proud for what I hate, but I can be thankful, for even though it's meant for hate, it is with love.
How? Chalked logic? What is this? Proud, and I thank you, and I thank you not, and yet not proud, mistress meaning you? Thank me, no thanks, no proud me, no proud, but fell your joints, thanks Thursday, next, to do with Paris, to Paris, to St. Peter's Church, I will drag thee on her. Hurl thither, out you green sickness, carry on, out you baggage, you tell, face.
Flee, what are you mad?
Good father, I beseech you on my knees, please let me speak.
Hang thee, young baggage, disobedient wretch, I tell thee what, get thee to church on Thursday, or never after look me in the face. Speak not, reply not, do not answer me. My fingers itch, wife, we scarce thought we were blessed that God has lent us but his only child, but now I see this is one too much. And that we have a curse in having her out on her hilding.
God in heaven bless her, you are to blame, my lord, to right herself.
And why, my lady wisdom, hold your tongue, good prudence, smart with your gossips go.
I speak no treason.
Oh, God, ye God den.
May not I speak?
Peace, ye mumbling fool, utter your gravity or gossips bowl, for here we need it not.
You are too hot.
God's bread, it makes thee mad. Day, night, work, play alone, in company. Still my care hath been to have her matched in having now provided a gentleman of noble parentage, of fair dimensions, youthful, nobly lined, stuffed, as they say, with honorable parts apportioned as one's thought would wish a man, and then to have a wretched pulling fool, a whining mammoth, and her fortunes tender to answer, I will not wed, I cannot love, I am too young, I pray you pardon, but and not wed, I'll pardon you. Raise where you will, but shall not have house with me. Look to it, think on. I do not use to jest. Without Thursday is near. Lay hand on heart, advise, and don't, and you do be mine. I'll give you to my friend, and you to me not. Hang, beg, starve in the streets, for by my soul I'll ne'er acknowledge thee, nor that what is mine shall ever do thee good. Trust to it, bethink you, I'll not be forsworn.
There's no pity sitting into my clouds that sees into the bottom of my grief. Oh, sweet mother, cast me not away. Delay this marriage a month, a week, or if you do not, make my bridal bed in the dim monument where Tybalt lies.
Talk not to me, for I do not speak a word. Do as thou wilt, for I am done with thee.
Oh, God, oh, nurse, how shall this be prevented? My husband is on earth, while my faith is in heaven. How shall my faith return to earth again, unless my husband send it back for me? By leaving earth? Oh, comfort me, counsel me! Alack, alack, by heaven should practice stagnance upon a soft subject as myself. What sayest thou? Hast thou not a word of joy? Some comfort, nurse!
Faith, here it is. Romeo's banished, and all the world to nothing that dares here come back to challenge you. Or if he do, it needs must be by stealth. And since the case so stands as now it doth, I think it is best to marry with the captain. Oh, he's a lovely gentleman.
Romeo is just clout to him. An eagle, madame, hath not so green, so quick, so fair an eye. As pains hath, be sure my very second match, for it excels to your first. Or if it did not, your first is dead. Or twere as good, he were as loving, and you would promise.
Thou speakest not?
And for my soul, to all for sure.
Amen!
What?
Well, thou hast comforted me, marvelous me, much. Go, tell my lady, I'm going to have displeased my father, Lawrence, and I'm going to go to Father Lawrence's cell to make confession and be abloshed.
Mary, I will, and this is wisely done.
Ancient damnation, O most wicked fiend, it is more sin to wish me thus forsworn, or to despise my lord with that same tongue. She has praised him, and above compare, so many thousand times. Oh, go, counselor, thou in my bosom henceforth thou twain. All to the frere, to know his remedy, and if all else fails, I myself have the power to die.